Well, now, frantic one, settle back in your rockers, because it's time for another story. This time, Uncle Jazzbo is going to lay a little history on you cats. I'm going to tell you how the airplane came about. Well, way back in 1903 BD, before Dizzy, two brothers cut out from Woody and were doing a bicycle act in Dayton, Ohio. They were billed as Wilbur and Orville Wright, and in bicycle circles, these cats were considered mighty big wheels. In other words, a couple of real hubcaps. Then one early bright, the two brothers took off. They decided to fall by the Corn Exchange Bank to exchange some. On the way, they were pedaling a groovy four-beat when Orville said, "Dig me, Will, no hands." And Orville took off at a wild tempo down the asphalt. Then, pressing his luck, he tried to make a turn. But the poor little two-wheeler hadn't been turned on in weeks, and it flipped. Orville tried to fake his way through, but when one of the tires blew a clinker, he did a one-and-a-half with a full twist. And she wasn't bad at that. Climbing out from the spokes, he spake, "Man, these bicycles are the lowest." "I'm hip," said Wilbur, "but I can't see walking either. That heel and toe action is nowhere." "You're so right," said Orville, "but what other way is there to go anyplace?" At that moment, right on cue, a wild goose flew by overhead. Taking a gander at the goose, Wilbur said, "Man, what a crazy way to get around. Why don't we do something like that?" Orville picked up on the idea immediately, and the two brothers came on like Edison, started inventing like the coolest in their machine shop. Well, after 3 weeks, they'd finished the gig, and there in the center of the room was the result. It had feathers, it looked like a giant wild goose, and it sounded a little like Frankie Lane. But after repeated tests, the brothers discovered that they had goofed because it wouldn't fly. The very best they could get from it were a couple eggs now and then. Well, for the second experiment, Orville came up with a weirdo. They borrowed a crazy cap with a propeller on it from a passing boy, and Orville cleverly installed a motor in the hat to turn the propeller. To test his brainchild, he tried the hat on Wilbur for size and started the engine. And quickly, Wilbur's head rose into the air. But as his feet were still on the ground, this proved to be quite a drag, so experiment two was put in the get lost file. Well, it was the third try that made the history books for Wilbur and Orville. They decided to make it to Kitty Hawk because they heard the breeze there was the most. They were hoping that maybe the breeze would hit the wings and move the ship and bring the moolah back to them. So Orville wheeled out their wild contraption and Wilbur juiced up the tank. But after a few tries, that gizmo wouldn't get off the ground. So they poured some more juice and they tried and they made with the juice again and they tried again, but nothing. Well, finally, Orville, trying the hardest, putt-putted down the field once more, and Wilbur yelled at him, "Hey, Dad, how about some more juice?" And then from Orville came the now immortal words. He said, "Save it, man, I'm flying." And flying he was, chums. Flying he was.